Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Today we'll see one of the more dangerous passing offenses. The Bengals are top 10 in passing TDs, and they'll go against the Browns, who are very aware of what they'll be dealing with.
Larry, it's the NFL on EA Sports, and there you get a look at Paul Brown Stadium on the banks of the Ohio River in Cincinnati. This crowd loves their orange and black. The scene just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Cleveland Browns. Five on offense. Leading the troops out there on the field is Cody Kessler, the second-year quarterback out of U.S.
in 2016.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson.
It'll be run after catch, usually very impressive.
On second down, Johnson. And he'll be brought down, losing.
Eyes up, head up, run right through.
Kessler wants to throw. Finding his safety valve here, that's complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard. From the shotgun, Kessler. And he couldn't hang on to it. Fourth. And Parkey's kick is good. Here come the Bengals now to take over. They'll be led out by the former Texas Christian University Horned Frog, Andy Dalton.
Well, he did go, and the defense got on him a little bit, good-naturedly, but they're letting him know you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, two touchdowns.
But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Here's Dalton, and he's taken down. This will
exactly that. But they're facing a team where getting to the quarterback is a mindset. It's a mantra for them. And they play a game within the game, and you know what it is?
They go play action here on first down. Throwing deep here for Coleman. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Corey Coleman, 84 yards. And the Browns were able to strike quickly for six. It took them a while to get their speedster involved, but they found him downfield there.
And what we've discovered as we've watched games is the speedster doesn't have to have a lot of catches, doesn't have to have volume in order to have a huge impact on the game. His speed scares the heck out of defenses, and other guys can capitalize, but when you have the 15 against your squad.
Dalton. And complete into the arms of LaFell. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Giovanni Bernard, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals able to get this back within a touchdown. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. The team know they were coming after him.
Kessler throwing now. He's going to air one out. And incomplete there, a nice hit.
Another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did, couldn't connect, but as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. Kessler now to throw. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And the Bengals grab it. And he'll bring it back to his first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with looking for Green, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamar Taylor.
But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go.
And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own six.
But you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
On first and 10, it's Kessler. Looking for Britt, intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for Bengals TD. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
Look looking for some space. You know, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now...
Looking for Brett, intercepted. Picked off by the great one, Darrell Revis. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for Bengals TV.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive backs, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier down their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
And this is LaFell. It's caught. And he'll be brought down.
And if there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover.
Man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A.J. Green, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Bengals add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude.
A first down throw coming for Dalton. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And they will... Throwing is Kessler on third down. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line.
Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
And it's going to be batted down. And we'll... Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping...
Feel the same way nowadays.
The age-old argument. Then you could say on the other side, if you're going to get angry about it, stop. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jason McCourty. And he will take this all the way up past the 40. From the gun on third, Kessler. And he is out of bounds. To throw again is Kessler. He's going to go down here. A sack. Here we go. Kessler on fourth down. And this is incomplete.
They have themselves in a good spot on third down.
Defense still with 3 timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys that's
skeptical about it, or did you trust it? But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice, got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So for the Bengals, they just keep on rolling as they move to 9-2 with a win here. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Pittsburgh Steelers come to town. Meanwhile, for the Browns, their luck may have run out as they fall to 4-7 now on the year. And they will try to turn it around next week as they head down to...